Powerful queen, beautiful thing, follow your dreams, yeah. It's not what they say, but what they need, follow your dreams, yeah. Anything you put your mind to, if you believe,
gotta believe.
Anything you put your mind to, gotta believe,
gotta believe, yeah.
If you believe, yeah. Gotta believe, yeah.
Hi guys, I'm Michelle.
And I'm Ebenezer.
And this is my boyfriend. We're in a relationship. So the first question is, how did we meet?
Why did we meet?
We met in grad school in Mississippi. And I used to say hi to him all the time.
And I paid her no attention.
You're right.
I didn't used to say that. You would say hi and I would just...
Yeah, but then you also said other stuff. Anyway, well, he was waving at me one day because he thought I was one of my friends. And I waved back. And then
it was not her.
It was not my friend, it was me. So I was like, oh, this guy's friendly. Odd. Fast forward, we met at a party, or like formally, like at a party that I put on at my friend Chris's house. Hey, Chris. and you were there, and I just kind of asked you what was your name or something like that. And then he followed me like a lost puppy all throughout the party.
Okay, I did not follow her like a lost puppy. Okay, so let's stop that.
Okay. Follow me like a lost puppy all throughout the party. And, you know, here we are today.
That's not how that happened. Okay.
Shout out, ask my friends.
You met in school.
We met in grad school.
Okay.
I'm Rataja.
Stefan.
We've been together how many years?
Ever.
What's ever?
9 years and some change.
Yeah, 9 years. November, what? You forgot.
29th.
All right, 29th. All right, so... The first question is, how did we meet?
She dogged me, like, bad. But we met at on UT campus through mutual friends, basically. It was, a party going to, or you was going to.
Yeah.
I was down there, and... end up seeing her in the in the side corner. She was all, I guess she wasn't dolled up or nothing, but to me, it was the best thing yet. So, I guess curls?
You had
a bonnet on?
Yeah, I had on a bonnet.
Yeah, she had a bonnet on. But I didn't care. She was fine to me, so I was like, hey, you know, what's your name? And she hit me with the beatbox, like, this here, like. Then she tell all the friends, why the ugly ones gotta holler at me and all this other stuff.
Oh, you gotta put that in here.
But that's how we met. And then a couple years later, I came back down from college or whatever. Then we met at a gas station. Her friend was at a gas station. And I had walked her back to the car. Little did I know she was in the car. So she was in the car. She looked at me, and I looked at her. I was like, dang, is that the same girl? Then I looked again. Pretty much it was the same girl, but she was ear-to-ear cheesing.
I didn't think he was the same guy. So,
yeah. What changed?
I call them baby dreads. They look like little hot Cheetos at the time. And then by the time I saw him next time, his dreads were longer. He had been working out at football camp.
Doggy.
Hi, I'm Jess. I'm a second year dental student. I'm talking about my relationship with my boyfriend, Connor. We met on Tinder about 5 months ago. So we met while I was in dental school, right about at the end of my first year. And he's also in school. He's getting his master's degree. And at the time we met, he also was writing a book, and he teaches computer programming in Boston as well.
Hello everyone, my name is Keith January, and this is my girlfriend Sierra Smith. I'm in dental school. We do have a long distance relationship. I stay up here in Boston and she's back in Mississippi as a RN, as well as being in school to become a nurse practitioner. Our first question is, how did you meet? And truth be told, we kind of met through social media. I slid in her DMs, mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. I mean, it worked. So that's how we're here.
And here we are.
Brag.
Hi, my name is Kendra Lee. Go by Ken.
I'm Yadley. I go by Yaddy.
All right, cool. Okay, so first question, how did you meet?
We met in high school.
Yeah, we met in high school.
Eighth period, AP Gov.
Mr. And comparative Man's politics. It was AP government and, and you were comparative politics.
Okay. I wasn't there.
I kind of was paying attention in the past, but I really had no interest in U.S. government and comparative politics. By the way, I sat in the row behind her, so.
He was a weird kid in class that never said, that never spoke. So, like, he would be like, we'd walk in, so, like, me and my best friend, Ely, we'd walk in class, and then it'd be like, oh, hi, Ken. He'd just be like, hi.
It'd be, hi, Ken, really.
Hi,
Kimberly. Hi. I wasn't trying to hold any conversation. But, yeah, and then she started calling me stalker.
They don't need all that. All right,
okay.
Come on.
Okay, so you actually admit that you used to say that.
Because right. You are a stalker.
What? Okay.
Come on.
Hi, guys. I'm Bavia.
My name's Alejandro.
And so we've been dating for about a year now. And so we're going to talk about dating in dental school and what it's like.
Yep, pretty much. But we're here. What we're doing right now.
Okay, first question.
How did we meet?
So we both are second years at Tufts Dental, and so we basically met, you know, orientation, and you know, we're in the same class. So we just kind of got to know each other through school.
Pretty much.
Good morning. My name is Chris Hines.
And I'm Alex Hines.
And we are here to talk about relationships in dental school. This is our daughter, Camille Hines. That's her hello. So let's answer a few questions.
The first one asks our relationship status. We are married.
Happily married.
And the first question is, how did you meet? Thank you, B.
So I met Alex in Houston, Texas, 2013, in the summertime. She was in the process of becoming Greek, and as her future fraternal brother, we all got a chance to meet. So we met at a mutual friend's house, and we just kind of hung out, kicked it, had a good time. I don't think she was really looking at me. I wasn't really looking at her.
He was.
And we were just friends. So it was a very nice, cordial friendship. Is that somewhat right?
Yeah, that's how we met.
Okay.
He promised me that he was gonna give me a crossing gift, but he never did.
I got a ring instead.
What made you wanna make such a commitment knowing you would embark on this journey? Well, I just asked the question. You got an answer that I answer.
Okay. This guy. We were kind of going through the same journey. It was very similar. And yeah, I originally did not want a relationship. I wanted to stay single all throughout dental school and just kind of focus on me and focus on my studies. But I found somebody that was worth inviting into my life, and yeah, I guess that's how.
Yeah, I mean, same here. I think that once you find someone who kind of changed that perspective for you, then it kind of speaks for itself. I wanted to be single too. I did not want to start anything going into med school. I just wanted to stick to my books. And focus on me, but after meeting her and getting to know her, she kind of changed that perspective for me, and I realized that I wanted to do this with her instead of doing it by myself. Oh, she's being extra.
The next question is basically, what made you want to make such a commitment knowing you
would embark on this journey. So my dental school journey. Well, I was already in a relationship with Stefan. He was with me for my first time applying for dental school, which I applied in 2013 and didn't get in. But he's always been super supportive. He may get on my nerves sometimes.
That's called love. what y'all think fairy tale is, love. Love is grimy. It's hard. Like,
so although he gets on my nerves, I knew how supportive he was going to be. He's never taken the shine away from me. He's always been there 100%. So he was definitely the person I wanted to be on this journey with, although we have our ups and downs.
What was the question again? Why did I want to
embark on this journey with me? Like, what with me being in dental school?
Oh, because you're gonna make a lot of money. No, on a real tip, like, it was just something that I just wanted to do and be so supportive of somebody that just was my backbone from day one that I knew her. So I'm gonna support, she gonna support. So that's what I did, and that's what I continue doing.
Yep.
What made you want to make such a commitment knowing you would embark on this journey? So I started dental school, engaged to somebody else. We'd been in a long-term relationship. And so being in a relationship in school was something that I had always known. But being in dental school with him didn't work. And I think mainly it's just because it was the wrong person. I think that being in dental school can be really great if it's with the right person. So when me and Connor met, I quickly knew that I really, really liked him and I wanted to spend a lot of my time with him, or all of my time with him. So I was gonna do whatever it took to make it work while I was in school. And I think it's important when you're in school to still live your life. And if the right person comes around, I don't think you should miss out on it just because of school. Professional school is a long time. So if you're gonna put your life on hold that whole time, I think that's a mistake. I think that you should still get out there, you should meet people and have adventures and see where things go. And I think if it's the right person and you meet the right person in school, it's gonna work.
So the second question is, what made you want to make such a commitment knowing you would embark on this journey? So at first, we didn't stay too far away from each other. It really wasn't a long distance issue, especially not this far.
All right.
What made you want to make such a commitment knowing you would embark on this journey? You got it.
What? I mean, this is like a question for the both of us. Like, what? You don't know? That's crazy.
What made you want to make such a commitment knowing you would embark on this journey?
I don't know. I mean, she seems really cool, and from the jump, when we finally officially went to hang out for the first time, she just seems like we actually got along well. So it was like effortless. It just, you know, joke around, be myself, and then I think she was being herself. So I don't know, till this day, she was really being herself.
Like,
that worked out. So I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna really just like continue with this and see how it goes, even though I don't really like the long distance relationship. So
yeah,
I was just like,
neither of us wanted a long distance relationship.
But then I'm willing to make this work.
Yeah.
I
think we both wanted to try. So we tried it and it's been working. So, but if he wasn't so like chill,
yeah,
he'd be gone.
Yeah, you wouldn't make it either. So you don't even know all that.
What made you want to make such a commitment knowing you had embarked on this journey? I think for both of us, we were both, we're both in professional school at the same time, going through the same stuff. So I think that kind of helped when we first started dating and kind of figuring out, you know, where we would take things and things of that sort.
at least from my end, I just believe that if you're gonna do something, you gotta do it the moment you want to do it, which is, you know, the pressing. You just gotta do things when opportunities come. You know, things are not always gonna be perfect. You just gotta commit, and no matter what other situations are happening in your life, you just have to make time for this commitment, whatever it is. You know, it could be a relationship, it could be a hobby that you have, it could be you know, other things outside dental school. Also, you can't let dental school just dictate your personal life. You have to kind of make space for those things as well, I feel like.
Mm-hmm. The second question is, what made you want to make such a commitment knowing you would embark on this journey? That's an interesting question. So Chris was at, Mississippi College. For his master's degree, and that's when he got the interview for Tufts. And we were actually, it was your graduation day, right?
Yeah,
it was his graduation day. He got the email that he was gonna get an interview at Tufts. So we came all the way up here to Boston in a blizzard, literal blizzard. Drove from, where were we,
Burlington, Vermont.
We had to fly to Vermont and drive into Boston because they weren't flying into Boston anymore because of the blizzard that was coming. Anyway, we met with Dr. Kasberg, and Dr. Kasberg specifically said that both of us need to be invested in our marriage first, and dental school second, in order to make the whole process work. And that was important advice to me, because I had to leave my career as a teacher behind in Houston and moved here when I was pregnant with Camille. And now I'm a stay-at-home mom with her and a part-time cheer coach.
And I'd say the commitment has strengthened us. This journey has strengthened us for sure. But what made us do it is, I think we were really trying to build the future for the two of us. And we knew dental school would be a really good step in the right direction. The beautiful thing about my wife is she really pushed me towards my goals and aspirations. And so if anybody asks me a lot of times about my journey here, I can't say that I got here without her, in addition to other things. So what made us want to commit to this was the fact that I believed in myself. I had a wife who believed in me, and we decided to commit together because we knew what we wanted for ourselves and our future family once we started. Mm-hmm. So.
Okay, so.
What would be a deal breaker?
For me, being inconsiderate. Okay, so, yeah, we're both in school, and I have the wherewithal to know that you're studying, you're busy, you know, so I'm going to respect your time. So that's something that I guess I expect back in return. And if I don't get that, then that's something that I don't want to deal with, especially in a heightened situation that we're in now, in stress in school. And that's just something that I don't want to do. So if you're being inconsiderate and not understanding where I'm coming from and knowing that I have to study here and there, that's not something that, especially at my age now, I do not want to deal with. So I'd rather just let that go. How about you?
A deal breaker for me has always been somebody saying, oh, you're too busy for me. Like, as soon as you complain about my time, it makes me cringe. Like, you don't have enough to do. Why are you worried about how much I have to do?
Right.
Like, it just, yeah, that's definitely like a quick deal breaker. You won't make it past step two.
So what would be a deal breaker for us?
If somebody up here have a baby or get pregnant or some shit like that.
Well, basically he's saying don't get knocked up by nobody else. So cheating and having kids with somebody else, that's the deal breaker.
Yeah.
That's a deal breaker.
That's a deal breaker.
Okay. You sure?
Yeah, that's a deal breaker. I don't know nothing else to be like a deal breaker.
Yeah.
Like, we done been through the ringer, so.
Yeah. Been through a lot.
Yeah, so.
Nothing?
Nah. Nah, okay. you stuck with me. Like, ain't no deal breaker no more.
A deal breaker for me would be any kind of cheating or lying, for sure. And I think you have to respect each other above all else. Put each other first and always have respect for each other and appreciate each other. So if there's any kind of hiding things from each other, sneaking around, disrespecting each other, you definitely don't have time for that in dental school. So that would be a huge deal breaker for me. And I think Connor feels the same way, that any kind of cheating or lying is just unacceptable. But respecting each other is the most important thing.
Okay, third question. What would be a deal breaker? For me, it would be cheating. And the reason why is because I give 100% in a relationship. I give it my all. So, especially with this long distance thing, I know there are temptations and everything, but I stay strong and I just expect the same. So, yeah, that would be a deal breaker.
Yeah, and I can definitely agree with that. I mean, being in a long distance relationship, you definitely have to be, you know, you have to be trustworthy. You have to be willing to trust your partner as well. You just have to learn to just keep focused or stay focused and, you know, just try to deal with those temptations as they come. I mean, you just have to be strong in what you believe in and who you are.
Okay, what would be a deal breaker?
So, for me, that would be, I guess aside from like, cheating, controlling slash possessive. Because like, I feel like if you become super controlling, where you just like, I need to know your whereabouts every 5, 10, 20 minutes. Or,
okay, that's a little weird.
You get that to that point and I'm just like, yeah, they're saying it because I'm going to feel like you're not contributing to my happiness, but rather just stressing me out. I ain't for that because I'm already kind of happy, you know, just...
You happy with that? No, just being you. Oh, okay.
I'm happy being me, so if, you know, I'm going to bring somebody into my life, I need to know you're actually adding to the happiness, not stressing me out, so... What's your deal breaker?
Cheating. Seems like a top of that. In dental school.
In what?
In dental school. Oh. I'm trying to be stressed with your whereabouts, and if you acting right or not. I'm studying, but that's a side effect. Controlling as well, super possessive, like, I'm a free spirit, I can't be tamed.
So are you just gonna copy all my answers?
I'm not copying, you know what? Fine, you're not going first anymore.
All right, question number 3, what would be a deal breaker?
What's a deal breaker?
But like, what's...
There are no deal breakers.
They're deal breakers.
Okay. What would be a deal breaker? I would probably say, if I had to guess my wife, if I did not finish dental school, that would probably be a deal breaker.
That would be a deal breaker.
I wouldn't?
I'd fire you up, though.
I know you would.
We would have a problem. I don't know. What would be a deal breaker? So his first year was an adjustment for all of us because she was born a week after his white coat ceremony. And we're first time parents, no sleep. It was rough. So the late nights, it was rough on me in particular because it's just us here. Second year, however, this year, I think I'm a little more willing to let him, you know, study till 10, 11 o'clock at night. He's out the house by 6:30 sometimes. And we don't see him, but that's okay because I know what he needs to do, what the process is for him to get good grades and to pass and to learn what he needs to learn.
Yeah.
So the deal breaker, it's not the late nights anymore. Last year, I probably would have said it would be the late nights, but... This year, I've just accepted it. this is what dental school is. This is what comes with dental school.
It's crazy. And we've been calling this the season of sacrifice for a reason. So to be determined on the deal breaker, but as of right now, not sure.
Okay. So what is the most important aspect in making your relationship work?
I think understanding, how you just said, like just really being understanding of whatever I have going on, whatever you have going on, and just being able to conceptualize that and then act upon it. So if you need extra time to study, or if you need like some compassion with something, right, or you need you need a FaceTime hug, or just like that little extra attention, that just being understanding of like whatever it is that you need at the time, or whatever I need at the time.
For me, I would say communication. That's something that I believe is super duper important. And if you're communicating, and I don't mean just talking, you know, but I mean like communicating your issues, communicating what you want, what you need, how you feel. Like if you're communicating all that, I believe that that goes a long way in making a relationship work.
So. Yeah.
So what is the most important aspect in making our relationship work?
You want me to go down the list?
Yes.
Or your list?
My list.
Because your list, okay. Communication.
Big time.
Balance, or should that be first?
Balance is important to me. I am a Libra to the T. I need balance.
Y'all know what I am. I'm that Scorpio. You feel
get
me?
Out of here.
You know why. But balance. What else I say? Communication.
Mm-hmm.
Just because we like so far apart.
Time
is a big thing.
Definitely gotta make time. We FaceTime all the time. He actually will call out questions, exam questions, review material with me, just so that we can have that time.
Trust me, I can take a test now, as long as it ain't longer than, you know, maybe 30 questions.
That he lying.
Like, I know y'all be complaining, talking about it's only 30 questions. I'd be like, yeah, it's a 30 question quiz, test, exam. I get some of them right. Like, what's the bilateral? And
whatever.
My hand skills. And
I'm
almost a
genius.
I don't know.
So what's the most important aspect in making your relationship work? Again, it's respecting each other. But I think that something that's really important is making time for each other. I think it's so easy to be caught up in school completely and to miss opportunities that you get to spend with each other. So I think if that means I stay up really late one night studying so that the next day I can spend with him, that's something that I think is important for the relationship. And it helps keeps me sane as well. And spending that time for each other is really important. I know that not everybody has that in long-term relationships and things like that. But still calling each other when you can and communicating as much as possible, I think is really important to keep the relationship strong.
The fourth question is, what is the most important aspect in making your relationship work? I know I can speak for myself and probably both of us that the most important aspect is communication. I know I fall short on communication sometimes. I think that kind of leads into like the fifth question. But what do you say about it, the fourth question?
I agree. Communication is key, and patience.
Patience. That is big too. You definitely have to be patient with each other.
What is the most important aspect in making your relationship work? Communication. And Cosmo. Communication is very important because we are in a long distance relationship, so we don't get to see each other as often as we would like. So if we didn't talk for more than a day, that'd be kind of weird because it's not like we get to see each other all the time. So I think communication, trust, if we didn't trust each other, this wouldn't work. Transparency. Yeah.
For me, it's really trust because, you know, the distance is already like all the way in a completely different state, miles away. So if that's not trust, I'm pretty sure at some point her mind will just start wondering, thinking that I'm actually in some club turning up, which is most likely not the case. And I'm just like, at home sleeping. Yeah, so trust really is the thing to actually just make this work.
Yes.
Okay. So you're going to copy my answer. That's not, because you give like three answers and trust is like... Yeah, I didn't say every single thing that you said.
Okay, you got it.
What is the most important aspect in making your relationship work? I think for us, one thing we tried to do is kind of separate school time from, you know, us time. So, you know, yeah, we study together and whatnot, but like we try to also make time for, you know, our relationship, you know, whether that be going on dates or just spending time doing something that's not school related. So it's not as if our whole relationship kind of focuses around school, though it kind of is.
Yeah, it does, but you just gotta live with that, I guess. those things happen. It's just, it's part of who we are. We spend a lot of time together, which is good. It's something that not everyone can do. Not everyone that, you know, is in a relationship can do. Some relationships are long distance. We get the privilege to see each other every day and work with each other every day. And it's just about kind of understanding that you're gonna be spending a lot of time around each other and just kind of you know, doing schoolwork, and then when you plan other things outside of school, kind of make a life, you know, outside of dental school. I think that's very important. Definitely.
What's the most important aspect in making your relationship work?
Communication.
Ooh, I was gonna say that.
I know.
I
communication, definitely communication, especially with a child, more importantly with a child. We need to communicate our schedules. We have a family calendar. Chris has his phone calendar. When he gets his schedule in the summertime, we go through the whole thing, writing down test dates and everything that he needs to be prepared for, so we both know that we're on the same page with everything. Like, my work schedule's on there, Camille's schedule, she has her own schedule. Swim class and such. Oh, that's so wonderful, baby. And school schedule. So communication keeps us going.
I would agree with that 100%. It's all about communication. I would say us having an idea of what's going on and then now adding a child into the mix makes things very interesting, because she truly is developing her own schedule. And the only way we're able to keep pushing together as a family is we keep telling each other what's going on. So being open and honest about everything and trying to keep the line of communication open allows us to keep pushing forward and stay on top of everything that we're trying to get done.